Hi, everybody. It's TidBit Tuesday. Tidbits are back. Yay. And so am I. I just went on a trip to Iceland and Amsterdam. See? Amsterdam, baby. And I had a wonderful time, and I kept this journal while I was on my trip. And so I want to share with you in this tidbit different tips and tricks on how to keep a journal while you're traveling, as well as share with you how to use these Inktense blocks. This is what I travel with. They dry faster than watercolors. They're easier to maintain because the blocks themselves dry really fast too. And being an ink instead of a watercolor, there are artistic benefits to that too. So anyway, when you are traveling on your vacation, you take a little booklet like this. It's very lightweight, easy to travel with. And it's with watercolor paper, which is what I prefer. If you get one with the handmade paper, you're gonna have more pages in there to fill. 2 weeks was the length of my trip. So when I did a little division, that meant I needed to do 4 pages a day, every day that I was on the trip. So one, that's kind of a challenge. So one method that I used was to just be there on the spot and sketch what I saw, and then painted what I saw right there on the spot, plein air. Another thing that I did was I would take pictures or videos of different areas that I was inspired by, and later in the day when I went back to, well, I was in a houseboat, but you could be in a hotel, you could, wherever your accommodations are, I would just go back in the evening and paint it then, later in the day. And towards the end of the trip, I found myself having trouble keeping up. You know, there was too many things I wanted to see, and I didn't leave myself enough time at the end of the day to do 4 whole pages. So I decided to sketch out really quick what I intended for the page, and then later go back and paint. So some of you have already seen some of these first pages. You know, I did a little video last week when I was in Amsterdam, but here later in the book, you know, this was the last page that I painted right here. I have yet to paint this one, but I've sketched it out, so I know exactly what I want to do on that. Here's these 2 sketches, you know, and these different sketches. So what's great about it too, and here's I've written my plans for the page, so I don't forget. I've done a good job on sketching most of these pages out. But you know, it's really fun to be able to reminisce as well in going back in here and painting. And I'm going to be finishing this within the next 3-4 days or so. I'm just going to meditate at night and paint the rest of this journal and finish it. So yeah, super long intro, but I'm going to show you some things. I'm going to paint a couple pages in here with the Inktense blocks and show you how they work and move. They work exactly like watercolors. They just have better, faster drying time, and also if you let a layer dry and then you want to do another layer of ink on top of that, it's translucent. So you actually, instead of blending 2 colors directly onto the page, you kind of see through one color and into another, and it has a different visual appeal. So Inktense blocks are a bit different than watercolor, but not too different. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy the tidbit. Have a great day. And take a trip soon. Absolutely.